Holy Spirit, we will never be the same.
Come on, one more time. Up, I remember what the Holy Spirit taught me. He said, the reason you ask for the rain of the Spirit, he said, when it rains naturally, everything grows, the good and the bad. He said, but when I rain on something, only what I planted will grow. No, you didn't hear what I said. But what I did not plant, the rain of glory will kill it. You are to receive this morning that everything God did not plant, that the glory will kill it this morning. Your shout is not making the grave. I said everything God did not plant, the glory. Come on, bring it down. You come back up. Watch. So now we're getting rid of the wrong one. So now, right where you're standing, you start making decrees. Okay, Lord, thank you that my seed is coming up now. Thank you that my miracle is breaking through now. Thank you that you're going to answer me speedily. Thank you that you're going to bring deliverance now. You're going to manifest what you promised now. The right seed will grow. Come on, declare it. Possess it. Thank God for it. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise. We bring your word to your remembrance. Now let every seed we sow come up. Let every faith seed we sow come up. Let every financial seed we sow come up. Let every decree we made manifest. Let the rain of glory produce it now in Jesus' name. Come on, sing it one more time. come for me slowly. At least 2-3 people. Celebrate that your seed is coming up. Your decrees are manifesting. Hallelujah. Your miracle will flow like a river. This is your season of supernatural breakthrough. In Jesus' name, cancel all unbelief in the air. Kill every devil running around. Chase them out of this place. In the name of Jesus. Bless you. Half of them are seated. Those of you in front are more hungry. Double blessings on you. Hallelujah. Whoa. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. You don't think so. Miracles happen when you don't even expect it. It's happening now. I say it's happening now. God bless you. You may be seated. Welcome to Resurrection. It happens suddenly when you don't think so. Suddenly when it don't look like something is going to happen. Suddenly when it doesn't feel like it. Suddenly. Why? Because your faith is the constant. Glory to God. When your water is stirred, that's when you start shouting. When your water is stirred, you start praising. You start making decrees in Jesus' name. Glory to God. We welcome you to this resurrection glory service. I'm declaring it by faith. I've experienced so many miracles when I didn't feel like anything. So, when I don't feel like it, I start making decrees by faith. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You know, thank you, Lord. So now he's beginning to father me. I can hear the rain, the water, the water. Glory. Some of you are getting a shower. Hallelujah. What the enemy thought is failing now. The glory is canceling things. See now. I just had my own shower. But when it happened, he said, now, when I got to the grave of Lazarus, it didn't look like anything had happened. But I said, I thank you, Father, that you have heard me. He said the Father had already answered him, but there was no evidence. Don't you see? That's where your faith comes in. The enemy is making noise. It doesn't look like it. The enemy is saying, oh, nothing has happened. But you got to know that he heard you when you prayed. And he wasn't just talking and waiting on Lazarus to come out. He said, come on, roll that stone away. Hey, come on. Do you have some things you can roll away this morning so you can see your way? You roll some things away so you can praise right. You roll some things away so your decree will work. Lazarus, come forth. Hallelujah. 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 So you might be standing in front of a grave this morning. Hallelujah. But if you know the Father has heard you, hallelujah. God, command resurrection now. Man, I have a situation that needs a resurrection. I command resurrection now for me now. I'm expecting something to hop out of my grave. There's a breakthrough happening now. Hallelujah. Bless you. You may be seated. Amen. That's why it's called a life of glory. Because whatever the enemy thought he had all planned and fixed and to block. And you see how the glory just, he said the angel came and rolled the stone away and sat on it. Come on, I just feel this thing coming up in my spirit. Eh? God needs to humiliate some devils. Lord, let my angel sit on some stones put up to barricade me and to stop me. May the angel of the Lord roll it away and sit on it. And sit on it. Amen. These are holy unctions. You can't make them up. I didn't have it 5 minutes ago. As soon as I got on that podium, here comes he who sent me. And he started prophesying. That's why you grab it when it happens. You might be waiting for me to preach, but this is your service happening now. This is your breakthrough happening now. Maybe what I preach may not even matter, you know, in the light of what you're going through, but God is prophesying now, telling you now redeeming you now. Hallelujah. That's why you grab it when it happens, not when you are ready to grab it. That's the way resurrection works. Even his sisters were saying, Lord, by now he stinks. He said, come on, roll that thing away. Why? The Father has heard me. Hallelujah. I said, the Father has heard me. Come on, a 30-second praise break. The Father, thank you, Lord, that you have heard me. Thank you, Lord, that you have heard me. It didn't matter what I thought before I entered the service. Thank you that you have heard me. Thank you that you have heard me. Hallelujah. I'm making my decrees because you've heard me. I'm making my decrees because you heard me. Hallelujah. We give you praise. We give you praise. First Corinthians 11:20. We'll catch the visitors later. First Corinthians 11:20. When you come together, therefore, into one place, this is not to eat the Lord's Supper, for in eating everyone take it before other his own supper, and one is hungry and another is drunken. What, have you not houses to eat and to drink in? Or despise ye the church of God and shame them that have not? What shall I say unto you? Shall I praise you in this? I praise you not. The few of you that came from my old church, don't worry, you are not back there. We read this every Sunday. It is just for a few services. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you. Just because they read it every Sunday, it's the word of God. We cannot tear it out of the Bible. And I bet you some of the things I've talked about, even though they've read it for 40 years, they haven't seen what I have seen. An apostle sees Father.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Watch now. I'm about to give some of that to you. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you. So Paul is saying, what I'm telling you, I received supernaturally. I wasn't there when it happened. But the Holy Spirit was able to detail it for me. Precisely. And exactly. And this is what Satan is so afraid of. That the believers of today will come into the realm of glory.
Yes.
Where they can commune with the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord, for your blessing this morning.
Yes, Lord.
As we commune with you, Lord. Thank you for every giant you have already slain. Thank you for every miracle you have already wrought. Thank you for every blessing coming forth to give us total victory in the now. We thank you for holy unction and we give you praise in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So if I received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you. Watch. I was telling you about holy unctions, how the Holy Spirit can show you things. And these things are so important. I've shared some things with my leaders yesterday. And I'm going to keep sharing variations of the same things with you.
Amen.
Because God is saying to me, when I said that you have grace to break generational curses,
Amen.
It's not just in making decrees. The Holy Spirit has to show you step by step measures to take. And that you have to take the covenants he's already given to us seriously so that they can produce that result.
Amen.
What you just saw happen, it's a covenant.
Amen.
It's not because I prayed or didn't pray.
Amen.
When you carry resurrection by covenant, as soon as you get up because God said to do it, he just comes to testify.
Amen.
That's why no devil can plan for it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That even calls for a celebration that no satanic barricade will work on me. Hallelujah. Isn't that what the psalmist says? Thousands shall fall at my right. Hey, how can you get 1,000 to fall? They were entrenched and set up. But the glory went. He just kept walking. These things belong to us now. I said they belong to us now. Beloved, all I can say to you is enjoy the glory. We have these, we call them prophetic moments. The transition between the praise and worship and the rest of the service. And the glory of God moves. The word of the Lord comes forth. And what I love about this particular one is that I needed that word. And it came through my spirit. I have preached that text on Lazarus. Actually, the very first Sunday of Resurrection House for All Nations, almost 21 years ago, was on that text. But the Holy Spirit pulled it up in this service. And it was such a revolutionary breakthrough and powerful and miraculous blessing in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. That glory exploded and flooded everywhere. I hope it got to you this morning. I hope it reached your bedroom. I hope it lifted you out of depression. I hope it broke yokes off of you. I hope you got up and shouted and blessed the Lord. I hope you received glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Glory, glory, glory. Come on, pick up your phone and call 770-994-3777. Come on, give your testimony. Let prayer ministers agree with you if you have a need. If you need to get out of the way, this is the way to do it. Once the water is stirred, you jump in. Forget what you were thinking about. Forget how you felt. Forget what's going on. Just praise and praise and praise. I mean, go to YouTube. Watch some of these things over. Huh? The Voice of Resurrection. Watch it. I'm believing God that we will start our Grace and Glory Network. We'll start from YouTube before we get on the satellites. 24/7 glory, miracles, testimonies, demonstrations of power in the Lord our God. Amen. I mean, all the programming, they're all in me, you know.
family matters. My children and I were talking about the Arrow Conference, specially designed for pastors' children, leaders' children. All the warfare Satan is waging. We are ready to minister to a generation. We are going from glory to glory, strength to strength, victory to victory, until the Lord our God would have won every fight in our lives. Amen. Remember, he said every valley shall be filled, not some valleys. He said every valley shall be filled. It's us that forget what he says in the middle of the fight. Every valley shall be filled. Every mountain shall be brought low. The crooked path shall be made straight, and the rough places plain. And our lives shall be filled with the glory of God. When you are in despair, that's the word you need to hear. When you are discouraged, that's the word you need to hear. When you are perplexed, that's the word you need to hear. When you are disillusioned, that's the word you need to hear. Amen. Amen. I mean, I caught fire from that thing, and I am blessed, celebrating the goodness of the Lord. I experienced resurrection in that service, and I experienced it all over again just watching it. Amen. And I trust that you experience it too. Once again, the number to call is 770-994-3777. Sow your seed today. Support RHFN Charities. Sow your seed today. Help us finish the projects overseas. Help us. I know the hospital, I believe that we need a better CAT scan and a better X-ray system. When I paid for this, they went and brought me the old system where you have to develop and all of that. We want this new one where you just take a picture and it comes out on the computer. You can print it out. We need to get these things done. Come on. We don't need equipment donations because the American power is 110. In Nigeria, it's 220. In Kenya, I don't think it's 110 either. So if you come to Nigeria, you see thousands and thousands of American donated equipment that's laying fallow. The power doesn't match. Nobody knows how to use it. No, we need money to get the one you can use over there. That's what we need. Those of you with resources, God has blessed you. You can give a gift of $50,000. And it will go much further than $1 million you will spend in America. You will change generations. You will save lives. Premature children, we have incubators now. We are getting the job done. And we believe that one day when we see the Lord Jesus, he will say, well done. Join us today. Hold up our hands as Aaron and Hur held up Moses' hands. May God bless you. May God strengthen you. May the favor on this ministry come upon your life as you sow your seed. God bless you. We love you. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.